Shifting adults strive to remain healthy and active at home and in their community, but sometimes need help to accomplish this goal. This is where you can help by identifying which older adults might benefit from a preventative population health program. Hop Up PT is one such program with evidence it can bring about an 8-fold reduction in falls and reduce fall risk in older adults. Hop Up PT stands for Home-Based Older Persons Upstreaming Prevention Physical Therapy and is one of the programs offered within the Hop Up Prevention Focus programming model. The program has a vision to empower older adults to stay safe and active in their home and community, and a mission to provide early preventative interventions to senior citizens at risk of being homebound by facilitating partnerships between community centers and local physical therapists. The conceptual framework for this program grew from a need that was identified by community center staff. Staff were identifying older adults who may be declining in their functional ability, reporting falls without injury, or were reducing their participation in community-centered activities. However, these physical changes were not at a level that traditionally triggered a medical intervention or referral to physical therapy.
So I've been part of this community for over 21 years as Director of Senior Services. And I believe you need to really go to your community to find out what they want. My responsibilities are programs and services. So I ask them the questions, do community conversations to find out what they would like to see in their community. It's not what Karen wants, it's what our community members need. So the staff, and the staff would be including our bus drivers, people that work in the kitchen, the people that do programs, we get to know our seniors. They've been coming here for a long time and we start to notice changes. Maybe it's through walking or how they sit down or how they need to get off a bus. And we recognize that it becomes a risk for fall. So we try to get them into the services that they need.
A novel partnership between community center staff and local physical therapists is an integral component of Hop Up PT programming. The community center staff identify the individual who may need an in-home evaluation and then reach out to a physical therapist in their community who is certified in the prevention-focused approach unique to the Hop Up PT program. It is recommended potential Hop Up PT participants have no recent serious medical events and have not been hospitalized within the last 2 months. They should not have needed traditional physical therapy in the prior 2 months as well. This assures medical stability and optimizes safety for prevention-focused program participation. While prior evidence supports the program's use for those 65 years and older, this is a general recommendation, but not a requirement. Community center staff may observe an older adult struggling or hinting at physical decline. Some examples might include needing multiple attempts to get out of a chair, avoiding activities they once enjoyed, being more tired with activities, asking others to get items for them, or being unsteady when walking or standing. Other hints might include not coming to the community center if it's raining or lightly snowing, perhaps due to the fear of falling. They also indicate their vision, hearing, or other body systems don't allow them to consistently leave their home. Research shows that community center staff are indeed able to identify those older adults who are at risk for future functional decline and would benefit from the skill of physical therapist prevention-focused care. Prior iterations of the study suggest that the staff were frequently able to perceive these changes without a standardized tool. However, a questionnaire is available as a guide to screening potential participants. The Stay Independent brochure is a brochure available on the Center for Disease Control and Prevention website. It is a component of the Stopping Elderly Accidental Death and Injury, or STEADI. Here is the Stay Independent Risk for Falling questionnaire. You can see here are the fall risk questions, and here is where a yes or no response to the question is indicated. It should be noted that a yes response on the first two questions are 2 points, but only 1 point on the remaining 10 questions. After completing the questions, the points are tallied. And if the individual scores 4 or more points, this tool would indicate they may be at risk for falling. It should be noted that there is evidence that individuals with scores less than 4 had benefit from participation in the Hop Up PT program. Therefore, community center judgment in combination with this questionnaire is recommended.
So a lot of our seniors have been coming to our center for a long time. and we get to know our folks, and we start to see subtle changes in them, whether it be walking. Maybe we're walking with them or walking a little bit behind them. Our bus driver notices they're getting off the bus a little more gingerly, or our fitness instructors are letting us know that there's changes when they're taking the fitness classes, whether it be they're a little bit slower or a little more unsteady, or sometimes the seniors themselves tell us that they might have had a stumble, but they don't want anybody to know.
Potential participants may have questions for Senior Center staff about the program, so the next few slides provide a general overview. A physical therapist will visit with participants, both in person and virtually, for 9 90-minute sessions over a 7-month time frame. The first 5 visits are in person at the participant's home. The next 3 visits are provided by telehealth. And the final visit is in person in the home, with the aim of transitioning the participant fully back to community center-based programming. Throughout the program, participants receive a comprehensive risk assessment, home environment evaluation and recommendation to optimize home safety, individualized balance exercises, a wearable activity monitor and automated blood pressure cuff, health coaching to address person-centered health behavior change, and referrals to other medical professionals when it is indicated. A common question is, how is this program paid for? Everyone's insurance is different, but the HAPA PT program is covered at the regular rate that any physical therapy service is through insurance. It has been covered by Medicare and other primary and secondary insurances common among older adults. As with any procedure covered by an insurance, it is subject to co-pays and deductibles. Additionally, some physical therapy clinics will accept cash-based payments if an older adult chooses not to have the services covered by an insurance.
Let me tell you about our volunteer, Paul. He's 96 years old. He's been volunteering in the kitchen helping with the Meals on Wheels program. And we noticed he was slowing down a little bit in between doing all his different jobs that he does. And he mentioned that he had had a stumble at home, and he was a little afraid that he might fall. So we referred him over to Hop Up PT, and he would talk every week about all the exercises he was doing in his Fitbit that he would follow. And after he was done with this program, we noticed a whole change in not only how he walked, but his whole mannerism. He seemed more confident, he walked more confidently, and continues to volunteer to this day.
Let's take a look at how this assessment and program would look like for a real person. Meet Sue. She is 75 years old and lives alone in her home. She used to come to the senior center regularly, but this winter has only come once or twice when the weather is nicer. When the senior center staff saw Sue after a few months, she looked weaker and she didn't seem to have the same pep in her step that she had previously. On the Stay Independent brochure, Sue circled yes to the items on, I have been advised to use a cane or walker to get around safely, I steady myself by holding onto furniture when walking at home, I need to push with my hands to stand up from a chair, and I have some trouble stepping up onto a curb. When senior center staff calculated Sue's score, they came up with the number 4. Based on this, they asked Sue if they could provide her contact information to the Hop Up PT team. After this referral, a local Hop Up PT certified therapist contacted Sue, scheduling a time for the therapist to see her in her home. After a thorough assessment, the therapist began visiting Sue about once a month. And after a few months, Sue was feeling stronger, more stable, and was able to start getting to the senior center more often. As this program is growing and evolving to have a broader footprint, it is possible there may not be a certified HOPUP provider in your area yet. You are encouraged to reach out to the rehabilitation provider or clinic in your area, or to HOPUP PT team members directly to assist in making a connection. We encourage you to visit the Hop Up PT website for freely available resources, to connect with us to receive updates on Hop Up happenings, or if you want to speak with us directly to have your individualized questions addressed. This completes the Community Center Certified Ambassador training, and we thank you for your interest in Hop Up PT and recognize that you are the eyes and ears keeping older adults in your community safe and active. Please complete the evaluation form available on the Hop Up PT website. Once submitted, you will receive your certification of completion at the email you have provided.